Alright, I'm gonna do a review of Counterforce for the Wii. It's a single player game, came out for the Wii in 2007. It's a mech, giant robot with guns and blowing up stuff. When I first bought this game, I thought it would be fun. I got it for $1, as you can see. It came with the manual and the disc. The manual doesn't have any color, you know, typical. Just Wii game, pretty much. You can tell this game is cheap just by the star screen. You get to pick from three different robots. You get the blue one, which is average. You get the yellow one, which is defense. And you get the red one, which is speed, which is my favorite. This is the one that I always pick. It's the fastest and easiest one. This game has episodes. I went all the way to episode 4, and I don't really know how many more episodes are after that. I would assume maybe one more or something. But the first thing you can see is the graphics on this game. The graphics are really low for a Wii game. Yeah, the graphics kind of look like a Sega Saturn, Dreamcast crossover kind of thing. The game has different ways of shooting. You have the regular controller that you control with the Wii, which is the regular shooting I'm doing right now. You have the special beam, which is a charge in the left side corner below the lock-on bar, and then you have the middle one. The little red circle throws the like this blue orbs. As I was saying, in the left side you have the shield bar, you have the lock-on bar, and then you have the special charging bar. Down in the left side you have your life, you have your coin collector, and your different bombs. So overall, it's kind of hard to use the lock-on move, but I will show you right here, right now. See, there you go. The lock-on move throws like this, the missiles, and it's pretty handy. Overall, the music on this game is alright. It's not that bad compared to other ones. At the end of every stage, you come to fight like this different type of robots. It kind of reminds me of Godzilla. They have weird names. Like that one that's about to pop up here, and so it kind of it's just weird. It's like this one, look at the name, great. Anyways, you get these robot monsters and you get different ways of killing them. You destroy different parts of their body. As I was saying about the bombs, if you press 1 on your control, you do the bombs right there. If you press 2 on your controller, your camera switches to a little more like less zoom, panda kind of thing. Once you beat the bad guy, you get this screen that says that, you know, a little bit about the story, even though this game doesn't really have a story, it's just an arcade game. But there it is, the story. So every time you beat an episode, that's what happens. Every episode has different places. You go through caves, you go through oceans. Right now I'm in the cave, so it's alright, it's not that bad. The game, you get to fight this weird looking robot thing, and it's pretty easy. It's not too hard to defeat, you know, typical arcade-ish game. I'm fighting the last boss for the episode 3. I'm just gonna say overall that this game is okay. It's not as bad as other people seem to think about it. Once you know how to use the controllers, that's the main thing. Once you know how to use it, once you know how to get out of the first camera, you'll have some fun. It's kind of hard because it's an arcade game, so you only get like think 4 lives. Once you're done with those lives, you have to restart the game. If you can find this game for $1 like I did, I don't see the reason why not. I've seen way worse games out there, and overall, it's okay, you know. Alright guys, but thank you for watching. Hey, stay tuned for more videos. If you like these kind of things, review games or whatever, let me know. Maybe I can do some more. Peace, people.